लेक्चर रिव्यू और रिकॉल अबाउट ए ट्राइंगल, राइट एंगल ट्राइंगल, राइट एंगल ट्राइंगल एंड आइसोसेलस ट्राइंगल. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी रिकॉल अबाउट ए राइट एंगल ट्राइंगल. बाहर बंद करना पड़ेगा. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल रिकॉल अबाउट ए राइट एंगल ट्राइंगल, राइट एंगल ट्राइंगल एंड द सेकेंड वन इज आइसोसेलस ट्राइंगल. आइसोसेलस ट्राइंगल द फर्स्ट वन इज द राइट एंगल ट्राइंगल. ट्राइंगल इज एनी फिगर. Triangle is any figure which has three sides. But in a right angle triangle is a figure which has three sides but containing one angle of 90 degree. The one angle of a right angle triangle is of 90 degree. The one angle of right angle triangle is of 90 degree. Or we can say that the two lines of a right angle triangles are perpendicular to each other. Which two lines are? This line and this line, they both are perpendicular to each other. Such triangle is called a right angle triangle. Such triangle is called a right angle triangle. This is the right angle triangle. Right angle triangle. Right angle triangle. Now, what is an isosceles triangle? Isosceles triangle is a triangle in which two sides are equal. Isosceles triangle is a triangle in which two sides are equal. Which two sides? Suppose this side is equal to this side. If they these both sides are equal to each other, then such triangle is called a isosceles triangle. In isosceles triangle, opposite angles of equal sides are also equal. Opposite angle of equal sides are also equal. Means this angle and this angle is equal to each other. Opposite sides of equal opposite angles of equal sides are equal. This is called isosceles triangle. Isosceles triangle. Now we come across the exercise 1.6 and we come across exercise. On page number 28, exercise 1.6. Question number 4. In question number 4, the third angle of an isosceles triangle. The third angle of an isosceles triangle is 16 degree less than the sum of the two angles, two equal angles. Find 3 angles of triangle. Here the given question is, we have an isosceles triangle. First of all, here we draw isosceles triangle. Then what is the condition? We apply the condition of the question on an isosceles triangle and formed the equations, simultaneous equations. First of all, the isosceles triangle is, as we earlier described about the isosceles triangle in which two sides are equal. We suppose these two sides are equal and corresponding or opposite angle of these sides are also equal. Opposite angle is this and opposite angle is this. Suppose we say the opposite angle which are equal, we let these angles, the first angle x, suppose, and the second angle is y. This is an isosceles triangle in which we suppose the same angle which are x and the other angle which is y. According to the condition, the third angle of an isosceles triangle, which one third angle? Y. The third angle of an isosceles triangle is 16 less. This y is 16 less than the sum of the other two angles. Other two angles are x and x. Clear? First of all, we write the condition of a triangle which is x plus x plus y is equal to 180 degree, because we know that the sum of all the angles of a triangle becomes 180. This equation on simplifying becomes 2x plus y is equal to 180. Now we call this equation number 1. This equation becomes 2x plus y is equal to 180. Now we use the condition of the question. Condition of the question is the third angle, which is y, of an isosceles triangle is 16 less than the sum of the two angles. Sum of two angle is 2x. Y is 16 less than the sum of the other two triangles. If we want to place equal sign between these two, then we add 16 with y, because in the condition there is written that the third angle is 16 less than the sum of the other two triangles. Sum of the angles are 2x. Y is less than 2x. How much time? 16. Therefore, we add 16 in y, then it becomes equal. The other equation is 2x minus y is equal to 16. We called it equation number 2. These two simultaneous equation, we solve this simultaneous equation by the Cramer rule. How we solve this simultaneous equation by Cramer rule? 2x plus, the first equation is 2x plus y is equal to 180 degree, and the second one is 2x minus y is equal to 16 degree. 2x minus y is equal to 16 degree. Now we solve it with the help of Cramer rule. First of all, we convert these two simultaneous equations in matrices form. We write the coefficients of the variables. First coefficient is 2, here we write the first coefficient 2. Other coefficient is 1, here we write the coefficient 1. The second one coefficient is 2, 2. Here the coefficient is negative 1, we write here negative 1. Then we have x and y is equal to 180 degree and 16 degree. Now we call these matrices A, X, and then B. First of all, we find A. A is equal to 2, 2, 1, negative 1. What is AX? AX is equal to 180 degree divided, 180 and 16, 1 and minus 1. Instead of values of X, we replace the matrix B instead of values of X. That is, in the first column we replace the matrix B. Similarly, for AY, we write instead of y, the matrix B, which is 180 and 16, and other values are same, which are 2 and 2. Now we find the determinant of these matrices. Determinant of A, which is 2, 2, 1, negative 1. What is the determinant of A? 2 into negative 1, negative 1 into 2. It becomes negative 2, negative 2, that is negative 4. Similarly, we find the determinant of AX. Determinant of AX becomes 180, 1, 16, negative 1. After solving, 180 into negative 1, negative 1 into 16. It becomes negative 196. Similarly, for AY, we have 180 and 16. It becomes 2 into 16, negative 180 into 2. After solving, we get 32 means 328, negative 328. Now we use these values to find the values of X and Y. First of all, X is equal to determinant of AX divided by determinant of A. What is the determinant of AX? Determinant of AX is negative 196 and determinant of A is negative 4. Similarly, after simplification, negative sign is cancelled with negative sign, 4 1 times and 4 49 times. X is equal to 49 degree. Now we find Y. Y is equal to determinant of AY divided by determinant of A. What is Y? Determinant of AY is minus 328 divided by negative 4. After cancellation, 4 1 times 4, it becomes 82. Negative 4, it becomes 82. Y is equal to 82. These are the two angles. The third angle is same as that of the 49. Therefore, all three angles are, the first angle is 49, the second one is also 49 because of the same angle, and the third one is 82 degree, which is our required answer. It's clear to everyone? Now we come across the next question. The next question we also solve it is with the help of a Cramer rule. The next question is question number 5. 1. Acute angle of a right triangle is 12 more than twice the other acute angle. Find acute angle of right triangle. Solution is, first of all, here we draw the right triangle. Right triangle is as we described earlier, the right triangle, the triangle in which one angle is of 90 degree. One angle is of 90 degree. Suppose here we call the other two angles, this we called it X and the other one angle we called it Y. These X and Y are acute angles. why we call these acute angle, because these two angles are less than of 90 degree. That's why they both are of acute angle. According to condition of our triangle, sum of these two acute angle in a right angle triangle becomes 90 degree. Sum of these two acute angle is of the other condition is one of the acute angle, we suppose one of the acute angle that x is 12 more. This x is 12 more. Then twice means two times of y, the other acute angle. Therefore, we write it as x is equal to 2y plus 12. How? This x is 12 more than twice of y. We write twice of y. This x is 12 more than twice of y. How much time? 12. Therefore, we add 12 in 2y, then it becomes equal. Clear? Now, x minus 2y is equal to 12. We write it's 2. Now, after solving, the first equation is x plus y 90, and the second one is x minus 2y is equal to 12. First equation is x plus y is equal to 90 and x minus 2y is equal to 12. Now convert it into a matrices form. 1, 1, 1, negative 2 and x, y is equal to 90 and 12. Now call these equations. First equation we name it A, x and B. We find determinant of A. What is determinant of A? 1, 1, 1, negative 2. We find determinant of AX. What is determinant of AX? Which is 90, 12, 1, negative 2. And determinant of AY, which is 1, 1, 90 and 12. Solve the determinant of A, which becomes 1 into negative 2, 1 into 1. Negative 2, negative 1 becomes negative 3. Similarly, solve the determinant of AX, which becomes 90 into negative 2, 1 into 12. After solvation, it becomes 180. Minus 12 means 192. Similarly, determinant of AY, which is 1 into 12 minus 90 into 1, it becomes 12 minus 90, that is negative 78. Now we find X and Y. What is X? X is equal to determinant of AX divided by determinant of A. What is the value of determinant of AX? Determinant of AX is negative 192 and determinant of A is negative 3. Negative 192, negative 3. After solvation, we have negative sign is cancelled with negative sign. 3 1 times and 3. It becomes 6 and 4, 364 times. The first angle is 64. Now, the second one is minus 78 divided by 3. Y is equal to minus 78 minus 3. After cancellation, it becomes 1 and 26, that is y is equal to 26. Therefore, two acute angles are 26 and 64, which is the required answer. Is there any problem? Then I open your mic, discuss it with me. Abdul Manan.
Hello.
Abdul Manan. Okay. We move on to the next question. Next question is question number 6. Question number 6. Two cars that are 600 kilometer apart. Are moving towards each other. Their speeds differ by 6 kilometer per hour and the cars are 123 kilometer apart after 4.5 hours. Find speed of each car. First of all, according to statement, there are two cars moving with the different speeds. That two cars, suppose the first car we name C1, that is car 1, and the second one we name it C2. Here we suppose that the speed of the first car is X. The speed of the first car is X moving towards the car 2, and the speed of the second car is Y moving towards the car 1. There is a condition that difference between their speed is differ by 6 km per hour. Their speed is differ by 6 km per hour. Therefore, first equation becomes X minus Y, that is the speed of the car differ by 6 kilometers is equal to 6. We named it 1. And the second condition is when the car covering a distance of 123 kilometers. Suppose both cars after moving from their place, suppose the car C1 at place this and C2 come at the place this. The car cover a distance of 123 kilometer. In how much time? In 4.5 hour. As we know by the definition of velocity. What is the definition of velocity? Velocity is equal to distance over time or a displacement over time. Here, if we multiply time with velocity, it becomes distance. Now, no, we suppose x distance and y is also a distance, not it's a velocity. Therefore, 133 kilometer distance and velocities are 6 kilometer per hour. The difference of the velocities is 6 kilometer per hour. Now, we take the second condition. The second condition is velocity into time of the first car, velocity into time of the second car, we called it V1 and V2, is equal to distances between there. D1 is the distance of the first car and D2 is the distance of the second car. Difference of the distances. Here we replace a sign of positive because when the both the car are moving towards each other, if we take positive sign with this, then we take a negative sign on the other side. Clear? Now we replace the values here. Time is 4.5, which is 9/2, and velocity of first car we called it x. Time is 9/2, and we called velocity of the second car, which is y. And the total distance is 600, and they both cover the distance 223 kilometers. 92 x plus y is equal to, it becomes 477. After minus n, x plus y is equal to 477 into 2 divided by 9. After more simplification, it becomes 9 1 times and 9 5 times and 3. It becomes 106. This is the second equation. The first equation is the difference between the velocity is 6 kilometer and the sum of the velocity is 106 according to the condition. The both the equations are the difference between the velocities 6 and kilometer per hour and sum of the velocities becomes 106 kilometer per hour. Now we solve it with the help of a Cramer rule. First of all, we convert it into a matrices form 1 minus 1 1 1 and x y and 6 106. Here we called the first matrix matrix A, the second one matrix X, and the third one matrix B. A determinant, which is equal to 1 1 negative 1 1. AX, which is equal to 6 106 1 and 1. At last, AY, which is equal to 6 106 and the instead of y, we write 6 and 106. 6 and 106, and other two elements are 1 and 1. Now we solve the determinants. The determinant of A becomes 1 into 1, negative 1 into 1, means 1 plus 1 becomes 2. Similarly, determinant of AX becomes 6 into 1, negative 1 into 106. 6 plus 106 means 112. Similarly, determinant of the third one, determinant, that is AY, 1 into 106, negative 6 into 1, that is AY is equal to 100. Now we solve for the values of x and y. X is equal to determinant of AX divided by determinant of A. What is the value of determinant of AX? 1, 1, 2. And what is the value of determinant of A? Which is 2. After cancellation, 2, 1 times 2, 56 times. Therefore, X becomes 56. Similarly, for the value of y, determinant of ay divided by determinant of a, what is ay, which is 100, and what is determinant of a, which is 2. After cancellation, 1 times 2, 50 times. That is, y becomes 50. Therefore, the velocity of both the cars are 56, and therefore, velocities of both cars are 56 and 50 respectively. Is there any problem? Then discuss it with me.
एंड
पर
रिस्पेक्टिवली क्यों लिखा है सर?
मींस 56 इज द वेलोसिटी ऑफ द फर्स्ट कार एंड द 50 इज द वेलोसिटी ऑफ द सेकंड कार और रिस्पेक्टिवली वी कॉल द 56 इज द वेलोसिटी ऑफ द सेकंड कार और 50 इज द वेलोसिटी ऑफ द फर्स्ट कार वी रिप्लेस इट means one car moving with the velocity 56 which is car 1 and the other is with the 50 moving with the velocity 50
pichli side dikhana ek minute sir
yes
thank you sir pe sahi mein ye slide
ji From where?
सर ये वाला समझा दे सर.
From starting. As we write here the definition of velocity. The definition of velocity is displacement over time. If it is a scalar quantity or otherwise we consider it a speed, then it is a distance over time. Here we consider it's a displacement over time, then it becomes a velocity. And if we move time on the left hand side, it becomes velocity into time is equal to displacement. Clear? Here we take a difference between the velocities and difference between the distance. Here we take difference between the distances. Originally, this is a distance. Velocity 1 with time is a distance because here we write velocity 1 into time. Velocity 1 into time is a distance. We call it a d1. It's originally a distance. Now, given time is 4.5. After converting it, 2 into 4, 8 plus 1, 9 divided by 2. Here we replace the value of time. The value of time is 9 by 2. And we call the velocity of the first car, velocity of the first car is x. Similarly, here we write time and velocity of the second car is y. Why we place a negative sign, positive sign in between both the variables or velocities? Because when cars are moving towards each other, their motion is of opposite direction. That is, one car is moving towards this and other is moving opposite side. That's why we take negative sign with one of the velocity. Here we take the negative sign with the y. That's why this negative becomes positive. Similarly, on the other side, we take a distances between the total distance and distance covered by the both the cars. The total distance given in a question is 600 and the distance covered by the cars are 123 kilometers. After simplifying it, it becomes 477, and taking 9 by 2 common from these, we get 9 by 2 into x plus y, which are the sum of the velocities. When we take 2 on the other side, here 2 is divided by 9. On the other side, it multiply with 4, 77 and 9 is divided by 477. After simplification, we get 106. The sum of the velocities becomes 106, and the difference between the velocities is 6. Now solve these two equations with the help of a Cramer rule. We get the required velocities of the car. Any other question? Please raise your hand.
No, sir.
Okay, it's clear to everyone?
Yes.
Okay, sir.
Okay. A little bit introduction about a second chapter. The chapter is real and a complex number. Little bit introduction. It's not our today's topic, but I have only six or five minutes. That's why to spoil this time, instead of spoil this time, we use this. Second chapter is the chapter number two. The second chapter is chapter number two, which is real and a complex number. Real and complex number. Every student is familiar with the real number. What are the real number? Most of the students are familiar with the real number because you studied the real numbers in standard 8. Here we write some sets which are set of a natural number, set of a whole number, set of a integers. Therefore, see, what is the set of a natural number? First set is natural number. Natural number. Here we write n with slash, which means that n with slash, which means that it's not any single natural number, it's a set of a natural number. What is the set of a natural number? Set of natural number is 1, 2, 3, 4, up to so on. Any one of you tell me about why we call these number 1, 2, 3, 4 a natural number? Why we call these numbers a natural number? Any one of you tell me why we call these number a natural number? No, it's not from one. It's not the reason to call these numbers a natural number. The reason is that how many pens are there in our hand or in my hand? One. This pen naturally exists. Here we see that this pen naturally exists in our hand. That's we call these numbers a natural number. Now how many pens are there in our hand? Two. That's why these numbers are called a natural number, because the quantity of these numbers exist naturally. Clear? Now, how many balls are there in our hand? There is no ball. There is zero ball. There is no ball exist in our hand. That's why we didn't place zero instead of a natural in the set of a natural number. Clear? The second one is whole number. Whole number we denote it with W, and 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, up to so on. This is the set of a whole number. Here 0 denotes for the empty space. In any room, we consider in any room or any other place, the empty space is considered in mathematics by 0. 0 is considered for the empty space, and all other elements for the natural numbers, natural things. Similarly, we write integers. What are integers? Integers इन विच वी राइट नेगेटिव और पॉजिटिव नंबर इंक्लूडिंग जीरो. नेगेटिव वन, नेगेटिव पॉजिटिव टू, नेगेटिव पॉजिटिव थ्री, अप टू सो ऑन. दीज आर कॉल्ड इंटीजर्स. वट आर द पॉजिटिव इंटीजर्स? पॉजिटिव इंटीजर, पॉजिटिव इंटीजर जेड विद द पॉजिटिव साइन. पॉजिटिव इंटीजर्स आर पॉजिटिव वन, पॉजिटिव टू, पॉजिटिव थ्री. ऑल पॉजिटिव नंबर्स आर पॉजिटिव इंटीजर. एंड ऑल पॉजिटिव इंटीजर आर ऑल्सो कॉल्ड ए नेचुरल नंबर. ऑल पॉजिटिव इंटीजर और अ सेट ऑफ ऑल पॉजिटिव इंटीजर इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड ए सेट ऑफ अ नेचुरल नंबर. सिमिलरली नेगेटिव इंटीजर, नेगेटिव इंटीजर, वट आर नेगेटिव इंटीजर? ऑल नंबर्स कंटेनिंग नेगेटिव साइन. नेगेटिव वन, नेगेटिव टू, नेगेटिव थ्री आर कॉल्ड नेगेटिव इंटीजर, आर कॉल्ड नेगेटिव इंटीजर. इट्स अ लिटिल बिट इंट्रोडक्शन अबाउट ए रियल नंबर. नाउ आवर टाइम इज आवर टू और वन मिनट्स आर रिमेनिंग. प्लीज सर्च अबाउट ए नेचुरल नंबर, होल नंबर एंड इंटीजर इन द नेक्स्ट. रैशनल नंबर्स, इरैशनल नंबर्स.
In your home, if there is any problem, we shall discuss tomorrow. Okay, my dear. Have a nice day.